A steady stream of civilians is fleeing Raqqa as the noose tightens on ISIS's de facto capital. And it's not just Syrians leaving the city, it's also those who came, some against their will, to live in the so-called caliphate. 23-year-old Islam Mitat from Morocco has found refuge with her two small children at a guest house run by the YPG, the U.S.-backed Kurdish force fighting ISIS in northeast Syria. Her journey to Syria started more than 3 years ago with a visit to an online Muslim matchmaking site, Muslima.com, where she met her future husband, Ahmed Khalil, a British national of Afghan origin.
He was in Dubai and he told me he have a job in Turkey. So he told me to come with me. He's going to do his job and we go for holiday too, me and him.
The holiday her husband had in mind, however, was in Syria.
This is a surprise to go to Syria. So when we went, when I told him why he didn't ask me, why didn't take my own decision, so I will come or no. So he told me, no, you're my wife and you have to obey me.
They crossed from Turkey into Syria with others like her and ended up in a special guest house for muhajirin, those who moved to ISIS's realm.
From UK, from Tunisia, Algeria, Morocco, Canada, Belgium, French, all the world. Everyone is there. Saudi Arabia.
Soon afterwards, her husband Ahmed was killed in the Battle of Kobani. She was forced to remarry, a German this time, but she divorced him 2 months later. She married a third time, an Australian, and moved to Raqqa, where she stayed for 2 years.
Honestly, I forget my normal life. And there is the situation in the last months, the situation in Raqqa, it's so bad, like the bombs of the coalitions and stuff like this, it's so bad. And sometimes there's no electricity and water, and it's not too much food.
In Raqqa, she had one thing in mind, escape.
Like for 2 years, I'm asking people to help me, but everyone, like someone asked me like too much money. They asked me like too much money, like more than $5,000 like this.
Eventually, she did manage to escape, but is now in limbo. Her Kurdish hosts have contacted the Moroccan government, and her father, through this report, is hoping Morocco's King Mohammed VI will intercede. Islam wants to return to Morocco, but worries about the future of her family.
I don't know where I will go. I don't know, because now my life is destroyed.
A holiday in Syria turned to hell. Ben Wedeman, CNN.